So smart home devices are supposed to be able to add convenience, save you time, and add functionality to your home. And there's been something that I recently started thinking about, and I have a solution. So we're going to get into that. So let's get to it. Hey, everybody, Robert here again with A to Z Smart Home. Listen, I appreciate you tuning in. So earlier in the year, we have some low voltage lights that are out in front of the house and through the flower bed and light up the trees, and they haven't worked for some time. The system's been on the house for 15 years, but the actual fixtures themselves went out. The main part of the device still works. So I had our landscaper come in and he replaced the lights and he had to rerun a couple wires, and they're all working great. They look great. But as we're getting towards fall now, and we're going to be unfortunately probably going through another time change, which I actually despise. I wish it would just stay like it is. But at any rate, the days are getting shorter. Evening's coming sooner. And I realized the only way for me to go out there and change the time of day that my lights are coming on and off is to go into the little silver box mounted to the wall and push these little pins in and pull the little pins out at the times I don't want it to, so I can change the time frame. I also had a situation where the power went out, and because it plugs into the wall, it just stopped working. And of course it started working, but it was off by like an hour and a half because that's how long the power was out. So they didn't come on at the time they were supposed to come on. So I got to think, I'm like, well, let's solve that problem. So I started hunting for matter enabled outside plugs. And unfortunately I didn't find any. It turns out that they don't seem to exist. If they do, I would sure appreciate a comment and let me know what you found, and that would be great. So there's a device I already have on the back porch that I use to power some lights. It's the TP-Link Kasa outdoor plug, and it works really well. I've already obviously have one of these. I already have the Kasa app, so it's going to be a real easy addition to where I don't have to install another application. I don't have to go through another, you know, configuration process. It's just a matter of adding the device. Then what I can do is I can just simply plug the box into this plug and control this plug using Google for the, you know, the sunset, sunrise options or time frame options. There's a lot of different triggers you can set to get the lights to come on and off. And so that's going to be super convenient. So what I'll end up doing is, once I get that set up, I'll just go into the box and I'll just push all the pins in to where it technically is going to be running 24 hours a day as far as it's concerned. But the power to that device is going to be controlled by the smart plug. So it'll only come on and off at the times that I tell it to through my automation into Google Home. So we're going to get this unboxed. We're going to get it set up. So let's get to it. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and do the unboxing, and we're going to get it connected here in my office. I went ahead and just pulled me a power strip up here so I can get it connected. And then I'll take it outside and get all that set up so I don't have to do this outside. So let's get this unboxed right here. Right. So pretty simple. It's kind of nice. They do give you this little like bracket to where you can like screw the wire. Let me take this out here. As you can see, the wire is not too not very long as far as the cord that comes off of it, and this would allow you to be able to like screw this down to the wall. So that way you don't have to worry about it, you know, coming loose or anything. So that's kind of nice. I don't really need that for my application. but that's fine. So let me take this off here. Take this off here. So it's nice because it is a two outlet device. And when you're not using, you know, one or the other, you can just close the flap to keep it protected. Obviously I'll have my device connected there. So we're going to go ahead and let's get this plugged up and let's get it connected. All right. So as you can see, the lights are now flashing orange and green. That's indicating it is ready to be paired. So I've already got the app open for my TP-Link / Kasa devices. So we're just going to click the plus sign, device, and let's go down to smart switches. Smart plugs. And then let's find this plug here. It's the two outlet. And as you can see, it's saying just next, orange and green. Yes, they're flashing orange and green. Connecting to smart plug. Connect. Get to my Wi-Fi. Join. Oh, I was already connected. Wrong. There you go. So this should connect pretty quick. I shouldn't have any connectivity issues like I had before. Most of these connect on 2.4. I don't think this device uses the 5 gigahertz band, but my Nest Wi-Fi pods shouldn't have a problem assigning it to the band. Nope, there you go. Easy enough. So plug two, I'm not going to be using. So right now, I'm going to add plug one. And this is going to be, I'm going to name it landscape lights. Next. And I don't need to change the icon, so click save, click next. And let's see, patio table. Yeah, I don't have the front set up yet, so I'm going to add a custom room, and I'm going to name this front porch. Okay, next. And that's it. See, again, super easy. Now, plug two, again, I'm not going to be using. I'm going to turn it off and leave it off. And again, you can see where the green lights here are in conjunction with me turning it on and off. So I can come down to, where is landscape lights? Turn that off too. So yeah, super easy. This is how it should be. So, all right. So from here, I'm going to go ahead and get all this unplugged and I'm going to take it outside and get the lights connected and we'll go from there. I'll be right back. Okay, so here is where I need to connect it. So as you can see, got this just plugged into here, and so that's what's going to go into that. I'm going to take you down here and show you this little box that I'm talking about. And you can see there's one of my lights there. There's another light over there, and I'll show you the other ones on the other side. But so what we need to do is need to come in here, open this up. Okay, whew, that was stuck on there, which I guess is good because you want it to seal up. But so this is the inside of the box, and this is that little ring that I was talking about. And in order to change the timing, you have to push these little pins in right here or pull them out to change when the lights come on and off. You can see there's a nighttime, daytime type indicator, and that indicates what time it's on right now. But obviously, once I get this hooked up, we're going to want it on all the time. So, you know, I might as well just go ahead and do it while I'm in here. So let's switch this around so you can see now that I moved past that, the lights came on. So we're going to go ahead and push all these down. That's a daddy long legs. And I'd say they switched off because it thinks it's morning. But I'm going to turn them all on. I basically want it to be 24 hours that they're on. There. So now you see as I spin it all the way around, no matter what time it is, they stay on. And that's exactly what I want. So I'm going to go ahead and put it back on, what was it, 421? So, okay, that's good. All right, we're going to close this up. Latch that back. And let's go up here and plug this in. And you can see there's my other lights there. So now you just need to unplug this, plug this in. And then remember, we're going to just use the one. All right, so get that kind of tidy up there against the wall. Okay, so there you have it. We got the Kasa plug set up. We got it in place. We got our automation set. That was pretty easy. Didn't take hardly any time at all, and that's the way it should be. So it was easy, and I solved a problem that I wanted to solve, and it should work flawlessly. So I'll check it tonight, and I'm sure, you know, it'll work. If it doesn't, I'll probably post another video as to why it's not working, but I think it'll be fine. So listen, I appreciate everybody watching and supporting the channel. If you do like this content, I would definitely appreciate a thumbs up. I'm going to be putting some links in the description below to the plug that I use. So if you want to check it out, if you do decide to buy one through my link, as an Amazon associate, I do get a small commission from that. So I would greatly appreciate that. It kind of helps keep the channel rolling. And I would definitely appreciate a subscribe. So I have some additional content that's coming up. And of course, I would like to hear how you guys have your stuff set up. You know, how do you assign your rooms and different things like that? Because one of the things that I do is I assign a room for the device, and then I name the device whatever the room is. So like, for example, we name that front porch. I find it easier to control the lights, devices, switches, plugs, whatever it is I have on that room, more granularly than just as a whole. Because if I attached it, say, to my front door, and I said to turn off the front door, it's going to turn off those lights as well as my front door lights, and I don't want that. So I have front porch now, which controls the landscape lights. I have front door, which controls the lights actually at the door. And I also have front yard, which controls a spotlight that's on the corner of the house. So I can control all those three things separately without any issue. I tried doing it differently when I first set things up, and I ended up having to go back in and reconfigure it because it just didn't work like I wanted it to work. But with Google Home, it's not a big deal. You can put as many rooms as you want. The only ecosystem I find has an issue with that is actually SmartThings, because they only give you a maximum of 20 rooms. So if you have more than that, you can't assign it, which is, I don't understand that limitation, because it's just a room. It's not like I'm connecting devices. Of course, you know, the Philips Hue has a 50 or 60 device limit per hub, which I actually have a little more than that on my inside hub. That I get, because that's the actual device that it's communicating with. But in the SmartThings situation, where it's just a room that I'm going to put stuff in, I don't understand the limitation. So again, awesome if I get a thumbs up. I appreciate if I can get a subscribe, and you guys are great for supporting the channel. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.